Gianna, your days and nights everlasting have been spent on this mega Goliath colony ship. A colony ship lost to the rest of humanity. Your neighbors are not farmers awaiting the chance to terraform the new world. No, you eat, breathe, and sleep next to the worst mankind has to offer. Murderers, rapers. Or perhaps you and your friends cast a vote for the wrong candidate that spoke out to turn against the new regime. Perhaps you ingested the wrong drug. Whatever it was, you were sentenced harshly. Years have passed. Gianna navigates onward into uncharted areas of space, now unknown to Earth. But no one could have foreseen your future. Welcome to Abandon All Hope. Seeds of Rage. Blades and Blasters production of sci-fi horror. Starring some of Blades and Blasters' finest players. Cypher as Zero, an old convict that has spent more time behind bars than he has free. Ghost as Dr. Manus, an unfeeling serial killer who betrayed his patients and used them for his own twisted desires. Sim as Hayden, a psychopath that has long been a ward of the state. Unfortunately, no treatment has helped his tortured mind. Matihi as Tammy, a philanderer and hacker whose luck finally ran out. Was it worth this one-way trip to hell? Seeds of Rage is a Blades and Blasters mini-campaign, presented by GM Tednock. Welcome to Perdition. Welcome to Episode 3 of Seeds of Rage, a introductory adventure for Abandon All Hope, the role-playing game. Where we left off was a fight in the mess hall, and Zero gave someone a red smile, which is cut their throat. And this was the inmate Slag, who was a inmate in your cell block, the new one that you had been put into. This fight started earlier in a work day assignment where he was giving problems to Tammy, as seems to be kind of a recurring theme as a woman in a male cell block. Zero hit him with a shovel, broke his wrist or injured his wrist in some way, and then later in the mess hall was jumped by Slag, the person in question. During this, they fought with Slag actually pulling out a shiv, but Zero able to reverse the situation, take the shiv, and cut his throat. Afterwards, the monitors spun up very quickly and tranked Zero for the second time in 2 days. And that is where we're going to begin, with Zero in solitary confinement. Bear with me for 2 seconds or so. Stuff that's going on. Alright. Direct your attention to it. It's awake. Zero, you awaken, your eyes fluttering open and seeing cold steel all around you. The walls are bare and cold and reflect your image enough to see a general shape of your body. You're not laying down. You're on your knees, prostrate, with your arms stuck out in front of you, lassoed around the wrist by metal clasps that are connected to the wall in front of you. Your head is pulled backward at an awkward angle, with a large hoop around your neck and a clasp that has pointed, jagged mandibles that stick in your ears. You're unable to move. Your legs are fastened by your by a hook, which is, you assume, attached to something. Your body aches from this position, sitting in it for so very long. You notice that you have pissed your pants. It's unclear how long you have been in here. Two doses of Trank within such a short time frame you have never heard of before. You feel sick and dizzy. At first you think it might be something you're seeing, something that you're imagining in front of you. But as you begin to gain your senses, you realize that is not the case. There is a stand on wheels with a tray standing. The tray is about your head level at this current state. On it are two very large syringes with large gauge needles. And sitting behind it is a man who looks quite out of place. He is wearing a convict outfit with his convict ID, which your blurry vision is not able to ascertain. He has short crop black hair that is pulled back from his face and a white, pale face. When he sees you come to, he stands and looks at you expectantly, but says nothing.
Zero, aching all over, can hear moans from he can't place where. His head swimming. There's a dull ache at the back. Jaw feels like his titanium and it like clamped down hard, unable to move. Lips feel dry, chapped. He's trying to create some saliva, but there's nothing. You hear this sandy, hoarse whisper.
Yes, convict. I am Dr. Randoman, your attending physician this evening.
And the effeminate voice can barely be heard as the man continues to stare in your direction.
A doctor. Last I checked. Shit stain on the cafeteria needed a doctor.
And he doesn't respond, actually. He steps forward and kind of pushes the table slightly away as it was seated between the two of you. Kind of like circles you and looks you up and down, and kind of quicker than you would expect, reaches down and pushes on your abdomen, which you realize has been tended to, but the pain is extreme as he jabs his thumb into your wound, or close to it, you're unsure. He does this without making a noise or saying anything.
Soft touch, doctor.
They never said I had much for bedside manner. Are you aware enough now to converse with me in a civil discourse?
Sure.
Wonderful. You see, I am the physician for this cell block B. And although it comes with some privileges, sometimes I have the nasty task of administering punishments. You see, the custodians have deemed you dangerous.
That would be an accurate description.
Certainly. Undoubtedly. Most likely. When the monitor sends someone here and call for me, that is the truth. But once I am done with them, they are dangerous no more. You see, patient, I am sent here with a vial of Kimcast. You know what that is?
Can't say I've heard of it.
It is a combination of chemical castration and nervous system, well, viruses. If I pump you with this, well, your testosterone will decrease. Your central nervous system will become impaired. Your brain stem will become damaged. You will be not even half the man you are now. No, I mean to make you a bag of meat. To be sodomized or killed or whatever any of the enemies that you have made deem it necessary. But you are very, very lucky. For I am a man that does not do the bidding of the custodians without asking why. Or not asking what is in it for me not to do such things. I know why I should do such things. I live in relative comfort here in this hell. I am separated from people like you, only to come and push a drug, stick a needle in your arm, pass the fluids into your body, and watch you shit, piss, vomit, and cry. You will cry, Mr. Tough Convict, if I do this. So, drop your pretense for this act of bravery, of defiance, of all your hates and your malice towards me or anyone else. I have seen this hundreds upon hundreds of times. You are no different than other men like you. You will weep. You will beg. And then when you are returned, you will be not yourself anymore. It would be worse than death. Your friends will shun you, your enemies will do, well, what they wish. A husk. So I ask you, how can I make this beneficial for us? How can I save you from such horrors?
What is it that you want?
I don't think that what I want you can give me. Not necessarily. But there are many things to that end. There are many things that help me in a day-to-day basis. But I ask you, what do you have to give me? What can you give me? I wish to spare you from this trauma, but... I must say, it must meet the end. It must be worth it for me. If the custodians find out, well, I'll lose all these perks. And I will not lose these perks, I assure you.
Well, you don't seem like the smoking kind, do you?
You're speaking of currency. I could always use currency, but... it's a little bit of a bore. You do not know how many times I've had this conversation with others. Smokes, I hear it all the time. Sometimes I take it, sometimes I...
And what is it? Work with me here.
You are a resourceful strong man, are you? That is what I've been told. Hyperviolence, I believe, is what the custodian said. But not just a dumb oaf. Smart. Smart and resourceful. But not smart enough to stay out of here, I suppose.
Some of what you say is true. And some... well... why I'm in here... is... somebody crossed me. Consequences, Doctor.
And you could not find a different way to dispose of them? Without getting yourself thrown in solitary and then potentially Kimcast?
Doctor, do you believe that me being in here may finally get you something that you've been looking for? And if that were the case, do you believe in chaos?
Certain belief that there is no right or wrong. It's only us. Chaos can drive a man forward and up, but it can lower a man just as quick. Your chaos as you hear. Either you could survive and perhaps prosper, or for all intensive purposes, die.
We all die sometime, Doctor.
Indeed, but it is our nature as human beings to attempt to stay alive as long as possible.
That is true. in that I might have failed. But enough of me. What is it that you want? And you seem to be now dancing around that little bit of information.
It is a interesting question. What is it that I want? Number one, your first idea is not a bad one. How about this? 50 smokes per week for a year. You see, if you say you cannot do this, or if you say you can do this and do not, I simply need to tell the custodians that, well, our treatment was unsuccessful. They will bring you back here, they will not listen to you, and I will perform this operation. That is number one, and it is non-negotiable. Number two, you live with an inmate. His name is, I believe he goes by Sarge. A quiet type. Yes?
Maybe.
Yes, is the answer. I will hide something for you to deliver him. You are to deliver it to him. And that is all. When you see what it is you are to deliver, you will find what you need to do. I hope you can deliver it in a fashion that will not send you back here. Again, if you tell the custodians, they will likely not believe you. And then I will perform this operation. That is all. I think it's a fair deal, your life for some pittance.
So, let me get this right. 50 smokes a week for a year. That's a little over 2,500 smokes. And deliver what to the Sarge?
You find it. It's in a syringe. Hidden outside your cell block. I believe in the showers, actually, in the drain. The main
what
drain.
What will it do to him?
What will it do to him? What do you care?
Well, information is key. If I were not to end up here, I need to know if it's gonna kill him. Two deaths in a row is not...
No, it will not kill him. He will actually take it and use it on himself. You will be completely absolved of any impropriety so long as you are not caught with it on your person.
Smokes and syringes for my manhood, I see. Well, looks like I don't have much of a choice.
Not really. Now,
tell me though, how the hell do I deliver these smokes to you?
Ah, the same drain where you find the syringe. The Negro in your party, in your block, he will arrange transfer.
I see.
Hmm. Now, as I was going to say, there are two syringes here. One is the full Kimcast dose. This other is what I will need to give you to convince the custodians that you have been Kimcasted. You will feel awful for a few days, undoubtedly. You will feel like you wish to die. You will feel as though you've been Kimcasted, but you have not. It is dead viruses in this. But it is the only way. I apologize in advance. And so, I will not start counting the days of your payment until you are fully recovered. I would say probably 4. But you will not feel very well.
Doctor, don't take this the wrong way, but I think talking to you may be the worst thing yet.
I'm so sorry you feel that way. They did not say I had much of a bedside manner back in the world. Regardless, this is your life we are talking about, and as we mentioned, anyone will do almost anything to spare themselves from death or torture or whatever. And so you will endure. I believe it. I have seen some men die, but I don't think you will be one of them. Now, are you ready? Afterwards, they will haul you back to your cell block and throw you back in your cell to sweat and puke and whatever.
Proceed.
Thank you. And he grabs this gigantic syringe with a very long, thick needle, and he walks over behind you, and you can't see what he's doing at all as your head is pinned forward, and you feel a sharp jab into your left butt cheek, and this warm sensation, and then suddenly it feels like you're sitting on a fire, on a hot stove. And that feeling begins to spread over your body, and you're instantly sweating so bad that it's dripping off your forehead. You feel nauseous, like you're being flipped over and over and over again backwards. And you vomit, and you vomit, and you vomit, and you expel your bowels, and suddenly you go completely black. And we will change the scene. Give me just a moment. Sorry about that.
Well, oh, not at all. Now I know what skill to take.
Isn't there a skill for not shitting?
There's
a
skill.
Doing a lot of that.
What is that?
Oh. There. A few seconds ago. Damn it. Come on, fucker. Okay. For Dr. Manis, Hayden, and Tammy, you were returned to the cell block, and Zero was gone for a full day. In the morning of that second day, Zero was carried in by a monitor custodian and placed into his cell. He is actually wearing completely new and
different looking attire. It is even more drab than a normal convict's prison garb. He has no convict ID on it, and he looks very unconscious. Currently, the cell block is open. You can leave your cells, so you can describe kind of what you're doing as he is brought in and thrown in there. And the monitor custodian goes back to his station and kind of goes inert.
Man, this would be just sort of picking dirt out of his fingernails and just kind of relaxing, sitting in his cell. And then see Zero get brought in. And get up and walk into Zero's cell just to look him over. Little medical diagnostic.
Mm-hmm.
Checking the heartbeat pulse, make sure the breathing's not irregular.
He appears to be, you know, respiratorily, that's a word, fine. He's breathing normally, a bit slow perhaps, clearly 100% unconscious. His face is pale, but when you touch his skin, it's red hot. You notice blisters along his lips and the inside of his nose and around his eyes on his eyelids. If you roll wits, I can give you maybe a little more. So you would know, you kind of have some idea that this, you have seen something like this in the past, mostly with hardcore chemical treatments for diseases such as very, very archaic cancer treatments that backwater folks still used. But this looks like probably like this would be a dose of 20 times any of that. You're kind of surprised he's alive.
Walk out. Ground. Is there a bunch of people like moving into this room now? Or
Radio is kind of just stand, like he's sitting outside that cell, kind of reading what looks like to be a newspaper. And Jimmy is kind of fiddling with this apparatus in the middle of the room, which is essentially a large conduit. He's like trying to listen at it, like he's trying to hear something. And Radio's just like watching him idly. You see Hayden kind of walk out of his cell and Tammy kind of leaning over the rail in front of hers.
I would actually go over to see Sugar Day to see if he has anything else that might be useful. Particularly looking for ice or some kind of coolants.
Yeah, so as you kind of go that way. Yeah, as you kind of go that way, you see kind of Sugar Daddy walk into the room as kind of people seem to be congregating on this side right now. What is Tammy and Hayden doing as Dr. Manus is making his way over?
So, no, go ahead.
Oh, Hayden's just being creepy with Jimmy. That's it. Really?
Jimmy is kind of getting a little bit more settled with you around a little bit. He's like, yeah, I'm trying to listen in here. So I don't know what you're doing, but no offense, but I can't hear with your breathing that close to me.
Oh, I'm trying to hear.
Just kind of rolls his eyes and kind of goes, tries to go away. Tammy?
So Tammy's kind of in the corner there, just leaning on the wall. She's not quite chain smoking there, but she's lighting them up pretty quick. Just kind of trying to ease herself. That was they brought Zero in. Surprisingly, she didn't look super concerned about his well-being. Not really going over. She's just more observing kind of what's going on now, and enjoying kind of her time alone, just away.
Let me ask you a question. Does Tammy have 70 extra smokes at this point?
Pardon?
Does Tammy have 70 extra smokes at this point? You've been in here a day.
Tammy would have 70 extra smokes at this point.
Okay. As Dr. Manus approaches Sugar Daddy, he has a very big smile on his face. And he walks in. Yo, man. What's up?
I was coming by to see what you've got in stock.
Not anything, man. It's just been a couple days till you fools bought me all out. I don't got shit, man. Got a couple of those power cell thingies, but... Nah, what else you need? You've just been sitting around here. I don't got shit now. I'm waiting for my resupplier.
Looking for ice and ice packs.
Ice? And he kind of looks at you. Nah, man. Don't got any way to keep that shit cold.
I see. Kind of looks around.
They bring your homie back in here? Heard a commotion. That's why I came over.
Yes. My homie is very ill. It appears that they did something chemically to his system.
Ah, shit, man. Kimcast, I betcha. That shit's rough.
Time will tell. He is unconscious. That's why I was looking for something to cool him down. He is running a very high fever.
Well, I can tell you, you know, me being a good supply of yours, and you seem like you're gonna, you know, keep frequenting the candy shop, right? Anyway, yeah, there's a first aid kit in that monitor station, but don't think it would let you use it on your friend, considering they're the one who fucked him.
Would it potentially allow one of us to use it on ourselves?
I guess. Depends. Usually they do. But, I don't know. You have to figure out a way to get it. You're gonna walk in that guard station without the thing calling an enforcer bashing you over the head.
Very good. Thank you for your help, Sugar Daddy.
Yeah, no problem, Holmes. He kind of...
Hayden.
Goes this way, and goes around, and he sees you're talking to Hayden.
Yes, Dr. Manus.
I require your assistance.
With what?
We're going to do a bit of role play.
Role play, you say?
Yes.
How so?
Wait here. I'm going to go procure our female companion.
Hayden, I'll walk that way a little bit. Hello, Sugar Daddy.
He kind of looks over his shoulder. If he's scared of you, he doesn't show it. He's kind of looking up at Tammy. He's kind of staring at her very awkwardly.
I like what you see.
Shit, what I saw? Saw her from the inside, boy.
Oh, you did.
Hell yeah.
Aren't the insides beautiful?
He's like, I guess, man.
You ever seen yours?
Man, quit killing my buzz with this crazy ass cracker talk.
And it's gonna go silence there.
Tammy.
Yeah, what's up? And she kind of looks up. She was pretty out of it at that point, just kind of staring ahead, smoking. Oh, what do you mean, Doc?
I have a vested interest in the survival of one of our companions. I would like your assistance to ensure that happens.
Alright. What do you need?
All I need you to do is grab something. And no, it's not anything that Sugar Daddy would have you grab. This is a medical kit.
From in there?
Yes. Let me tell you what's going to happen. I just need you to lounge around out here, looking inconspicuous, as you often do. I will ask Hayden to engage in fisticuffs with me and wound me. He will likely agree because he is insane. You will go in and grab the med kit and stuff it wherever you can put it. Does this sound agreeable to you?
Yeah, sounds, oh, you're the one getting beat up this time, then, yeah, I'm done. Let's do it.
Good. As a benefit, I will let you keep some of the sedatives. I only need certain things.
Oh, good. I'm having trouble sleeping, so, that sounds good.
Might I recommend engaging in less vigorous nighttime activities next time, and perhaps your sleep patterns will adjust themselves?
Well, I would agree with you, but I mean, 100 smokes is 100 smokes.
He just blinks for a couple times and then walks away. And we'll wait for her to position herself.
And Tammy kind of strolls back. Kind of going, squeezing past Sugar Daddy and Hayden.
Hello, Tammy.
As you do that, Sugar Daddy kind of reaches out and grabs your ass as you walk by.
Hey, that's, not free, you know.
Oh, shit, girl, you know I'm good for it.
We'll see. Kind of continue along and lean on this wall, lighten up another cigarette.
All right, Hayden.
Yes, Dr. Manners.
What are your voices saying at this moment?
Oh, they've been silent lately. However, they do flavor somebody.
I see. Hayden, would you like to inflict harm upon me?
Well, no, Dr. Madness. We are partners. You have a key I want.
What if I told you I wouldn't use that key to help you unless you hit me as hard as you could right now?
Are you sure, Dr. Manus? Because even I sometimes can't stop myself.
Dr. Manus takes off his glasses and puts them in one of his pockets. I am very certain, Hayden. I would like you to punch me as hard as you possibly can.
Let me hold on to the key when I get back.
You want to have the key?
I do. For a night.
I will consider it. Or, better yet, I will allow you to hold on to a key. A key. If you promise not to tell anyone.
I don't tell nobody. But okay. I'm sorry if I can't stop myself.
I'm sure you are.
Alright. With that, Hayden will a little smile.
Where do you punch him? How does it look? What do you do?
He's just gonna be looking at him and just doing like a full bag haymaker. No brass knuckles, no baton. Just gonna hit him in the side there with a jawbone and ear connect.
How does that look, Dr. Manus? Punches you. Sugar Day's like, oh shit!
So Dr. Manus has been, had his ass beat by police at least once. So this is probably still fairly brutal because the police are still trying to take you alive. He's not even sure this is the greatest of ideas, but knowing that Hayden will more or less do what he asks as long as he has that key as a bargaining chip, he eats the full brunt of the haymaker and just collapses to the floor, tries to sell it a bit to make it look like he's been just cold cocked real hard.
What does Hayden do after he punches him?
Roll me
a will.
Sell it.
Normal check.
Oh.
You do not have to continue to beat him. You're with the plan. Your voices are telling you to listen to Dr. Manus currently.
Hayden's still smiling. Ghost is looking at him, I'm sure. And Hayden steps in closer. Big old smile on his face and leans forward towards Dr. Manus's face.
The custodian comes flying out of the room with its mandibles kind of out, the tentacles, and the telltale syringe. Stop. What are you guys doing?
Well, once Hayden already, he asked Dr. Manus, he leans forward and asks him if he's okay. Hayden is gonna look at the custodian. He had something wrong with him.
Stop.
And with that, Hayden will put his hands in the air and back up.
And Tammy's kind of strolling on into the into here.
Why don't you roll a reflex with a D8 instead of a D12.
So
you just hit the reflex, and then you should be able to change that number from a 12 to an 8, and that'll change your die type.
Oh, shoot.
So your attribute, so... Flex.
Attributes and gauges, is that it?
Yeah, attributes and gauges, correct.
Yeah, roll a normal check.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, normal check. Normal check. My bad.
And then you change to whatever the
number is. Oh, to a TA. Thank you.
Anytime. Hey, that's...
So, good thing.
Mildly adequate.
Yeah.
So the monarch custodian's still bearing down on these two. Return to your cells.
Gladly.
And Tammy'll quickly snag the med pack. How baggy are the clothes that they have?
Baggy enough where you could cram this. This thing is not very big. It's probably the size of a sardine can-ish or something like that. Deck of cards.
So she'll kind of shove it down her shirt, kind of tucking it under one of her tits. And she'll exits nonchalantly, still smoking, and calmly head back to her cell there.
As Hayden's heading back to his cell, he's gonna touch Sugar Daddy's butt and wink at him.
Sugar Daddy just kind of jumps and like moves away and gives you a hateful look. That is inappropriate.
I'll see you later, Sugar Daddy.
You might, motherfucker. You keep doing that.
Oh, God. Yeah, Dr. Manus will get up and put his glasses back on and wipe some of the blood off of his face. Follow the monitor's instructions.
Return to cell. It kind of follows you up there. And as you both get into your cells, the locks clasp shut as it locks you in there. And it actually just goes back and kind of returns.
Hayden's just staring at the door over at Sugar Daddy.
Yeah, he's staring back at you. He's not pleased.
Tammy.
Hmm. Yeah.
I believe you have something I would like to have.
Yeah, I got it here. Is everything locked? Like, are we locked in?
You're not locked in, just Dr. Manus and Hayden.
Ah. Okay. I got it. So she'll come back out and walk over to Dr. Manus there. Mm-hmm.
He holds his hand out next to the bars.
And she'll reach back under her shirt and pass over the med kit. It's a bit warm now.
He kind of feels some of the sweat on the bottom of it and just wipes it on his pants and opens it up. And what's inside this thing?
So inside are your typical normal things like bandages, like things like aspirin, etc. You do see that there is a syringe filled with something, you're not sure what. On the outside, you being a doctor, I guess you would know. It is like a, essentially Narcan, but not for, like, opioids. It's kind of a general use, anti-poison-ish thing. Full spectrum. I mean, this is the future, right? So it's going to it would help a lot of bad stuff, drugs, disease, chemicals, for instance. You think it would potentially help? Maybe.
Put it in his pocket, and then go through any other sedatives in there.
You see that there's a dose of Trank. There is, nothing really that special other than that stuff. Mm-hmm. Bandages, sutures, things like that. General supplies.
So he would take the small dose of Trank out and hand it back to Tammy for services rendered.
Thank you kindly. And she'll take it and shove it back under his shirt. Need me for anything else?
No, that'll be all.
Good. And she'll light up again and kind of mosey back to her position over here.
Oh, Tammy. Smoking is bad for your health.
Really?
I'm a doctor. Yes.
And she'll turn around. Light one up. Take a long drag. That's okay. Appreciate your concern, though. Not needed, Doc.
How long were you usually in lockdown when after a little scuffle?
They end up letting you out for, so the day passes, somewhat a few hours. They let you out to eat. You go to the cafeteria. Nothing really happens of interest. Zero obviously does not go with you. And when you get back, you're free to roam around. But the monitor custodian goes up to you and Hayden, and it's flashing sign, obey, obey, obey. Kind of just a warning.
Mm-hmm. Obey, you say.
It doesn't respond. It just wheels back into its security area.
Once it's secure in its little cell, Dr. Manus would look over Zero, start looking at some veins, and tapping them, trying to find a good vein for insertion.
Yeah, seems pretty standard.
So you would go ahead and take the all-purpose anti-chem, anti-op, anti-everything, and get ready to do it, but then sensing the presence of heavy breathing, look over at Hayden. Clearly enamored with what's about to proceed.
Do carry on.
Not yet. I believe I owed you something.
Indeed.
And set the syringe on the sink, making sure the needle doesn't touch any of the disgustingness on it. Tell me, Hayden, if you had Zero's mind, and perhaps you're not capable of thinking like this, but where would you stuff a key that can open everything?
There is not a lot of hiding spots. I don't think he had it inside him from looking at his pants. It is a tough choice.
Let's root around then, and I will begin to search for Zero's key.
Zypher, where would the key be hidden so that even when you changed clothes it was not found, knowing that the key would not fit up your anal cavity and the shiv either, because they're both on your person?
So the mattress on which I sleep on, I found that there's actually a tear, and if you kind of move the stuffing around a bit, there's a nice little space in there that I would put all my precious stuff in. So my smokes, my key, my shiv would all be in there. And in case this room was ever tossed, it would still not fall out because it's between, you know, it's in the mattress.
Yeah, one thing you guys know from your time here in prison, the custodians are very good at watching people when they're outside in the open, but not so great when people go in their cells. They don't tend to toss anybody's cells unless they get tips from other people that there's shit in there. So it's very unlikely that happens just randomly.
So, after going through and eventually, I'm assuming, finding that.
Yes.
I would hand Zero's key to Hayden and look at Hayden and say, you're aware, I think, that the custodians are not very privy to our secrets in our rooms. Yes?
Indeed.
If Zero were to ask you where you got this, or what happened to his key, since there are only the four of us that know about it, if he happens to ask you where it is, where it's gone, you're going to say that someone tipped off his room. You're not going to say who. We're just going to say that a custodian came in one day and cleaned everything out.
Sounds good to me.
Good. Then you will get this. I'll hand him Zero's key. And I will keep this. And I will put zero shiv in my pockets.
Okay.
Alright. With that, Hayden's gonna gleefully shamble on over Tammy. Well, you could go ahead with your shot stuff first if you need to.
We'll do that first.
I would take the syringe and flick it a couple times, make sure it's got good pressure and everything, and then stick it in his arm.
You do. And you inject the anti chem meds into Zero. And you kind of are just looking at him, waiting. And unlike something like Narcan, which I think it posed, even listening, you can smack me across the head and tell me I'm stupid, but it begins to revive him fairly soon. He comes awake very suddenly. Zero, as your eyes flicker open, your body is in agonizing pain, as if you were in a furnace. That's how hot your skin feels initially. After a few moments, it all begins to cool quite rapidly, and it's almost like the greatest sensation you've ever felt, as if you were on fire and jumped into water. Only after, when the fire was gone, your skin was no longer burning and crisp. So feel free to roleplay how that is for you.
So, as soon as Zero gains consciousness, you're like, oh! And where is Dr. Manus? Like, any appendages?
Well, he would be next to one of your arms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so my arms actually reach out instinctively to grab, you know, like out of instinct, there's something like something's attacking me, or so I'm like, proceed to almost crush his arm before like coming to my senses and hazily making out Dr. Manus's frame, letting go of his arm, at which time the coolness takes over and
Dr. Manus.
Yes.
It is a pleasure to see your face in this dump.
That may be the first time that I have ever heard that. And I would walk over. We have toilets, don't we?
Yep.
We don't have sinks.
No, they don't care if you wash your hands or not.
Perfect. How shitty is the toilet?
I mean, it could be worse. I don't think you're just shitting everywhere. Knowing you, probably, or try to keep it as clean as could. Not very clean, though.
So with that in mind, I'll go over. Hold just one moment. You look parched. And I'll walk over and get some toilet water. From my relatively clean toilet.
Oh my god.
Swirl it around, try to see if there's no, you know,
floaters,
particles in it. Then.
I mean, it's brown, but that's just from
beggars years, can't be choosers.
Years of neglect and whatever. There's been a lot of bad things that have happened in this game, but this might be the worst. Drinking toilet water.
Good. Come back in, and I'm gonna have to ask you, Zero, how thirsty are you?
Botched.
Well, I would inquire with other cell blocks to see about the cleanliness of their own toilet water, but I have a feeling that my toilet will surpass them.
Are you holding the mug of water in your hand?
I am.
Zero just kind of half-wake gets up, grabs the mug as you're finishing your sentence and starts gulping the water down.
Ooh. think the English language has a word for what I'm just experiencing, but disgust and pleasure at the same time would be the best approximation. Oh.
So Zero's drinking the toilet water. Hayden and Tammy are over in the corner.
Hello, Tammy.
What do you want?
Could I borrow what you use to light your smokes? I'll bring it right back.
You would have matches.
She'll look at her matchbook. Look back to Hayden. What are you doing with it?
Oh, I just need to borrow it.
Am I gonna get it back?
Yes, minus a few little. I need to use a few.
Fine. And she'll reluctantly kind of hand over the matchbook, kind of leaving it on the flat of her palm, like as you'd feed a horse, kind of bend her fingers back so it doesn't touch her that much.
Well, Hayden will reach out with two hands, one for the bottom of the hand and the other one grabbing the matchbook, and then slowly pull him back. Thank you, Tammy.
And she'll quickly pull her hand back, shake it out. Hurry.
Yes, yeah. I shall. And with that, Hayden's gonna wander over here.
Of course.
Hello, Jimmy. And he'll keep walking.
And he's just kind of sitting in there on his bunk. And he just looks up and looks down.
Welcome back to unsolitary confinement.
Thank you, Dr. Manis. It was an interesting time in the hole this time. Quite a different experience up here than what I'm used to.
Something you want to talk about?
Well, I thought all doctors were alike, but no, not really. I met a special one down there in that hole. Do you take perverse pleasures, doctor, in what you do?
In treating patients or cutting people open?
Both.
In treating patients, it is simply a means to an end. It allows me to, well, allowed me to practice my craft without drawing suspicion to cutting people open in my free time. A means to an end. You don't need to be a doctor to cut people open, but it certainly helps.
Well, I met a man with somewhat similar tastes. Looks like he gains a lot of pleasure in turning people to like him. Olympic motherfucker.
Well, effeminate.
I think the word effeminate was coined based on him. Anyway, I had a choice to make. Either get chemcasted, which is, I prefer death. And the other is pay him 50 smokes a week and deliver a package to Sarge in the block over. Anyway, those are my troubles. Do tell me, what have you lot been up to?
trying to do what we could to prevent you from having even more trouble, with mixed success.
At that point, Zero kind of looks about him. Is the, like, in all of that commotion, is the syringe still stuck into his arm?
Oh no, I would have pulled that shit out. It's been some time.
Alright, so he kind of looks around.
Well, your help is much appreciated, Doctor. Much appreciated.
I have some bad news for you.
Oh. It gets bad, is it? Well, proceed.
Someone tipped off the custodians about your cell.
And?
They turned it upside down. What do you think happened next?
Zero kind of pops up from his bed. And when he does, he's like, oh! And proceeds to throw the bed over and start looking at the places where he had hidden his stuff. What does Zero find?
Your smokes are still there, but your shiv and your key card are gone.
All right. Am I at full health?
No, you're at the same. You actually should be at 1d4 more health than you have. Go ahead and roll it. So add 6. 2.
Okay. All right. At this point, Zero proceeds to, motherfucker, and he proceeds to punch the wall. Unarmed attack?
Yeah, no, you don't have to. You just punch the wall. You don't hurt yourself. It's fine.
Got it.
Who tipped the fucking guards?
That's what I've been trying to figure out. It's been difficult. The only thing that I was able to save before I realized what was going on is this. He roots in his pocket and brings the shiv out.
Doctor, you are full of surprises. Can I have it, please?
Oh yeah, yeah, I hand it to him.
Thank you.
And Zero quickly puts it in his pocket.
Well, I think I've had enough excitement and dejection in a single day. You wouldn't mind if I lay down for a bit, would you?
No, I wouldn't. If you require anything or if you have a headache, Tammy and I were able to procure the first aid kit that the monitor custodian typically has in his little confinement box. Just knock and I will come by and deliver the good medicine.
Actually, I could do with something right now. Something for a splitting headache.
He reaches in the pocket and gives him some aspirin.
Zero dry swallows it and just lies down on the bed again. And starts rubbing his temples and the bridge of his nose.
Anyone, anyone have anything to do during the day on this day?
We went to lunch, yes.
Yep, it's getting towards lights out.
Does that mean that Sugar Daddy also went to lunch?
Yep.
Where he says he procures goods?
Mm-hmm.
I would check with him one more time before lights out comes around.
Yeah, he's very irritated. You can tell that on his face. We're not sure from what. But nah, man, I haven't got shit yet. Still waiting.
You appear to be in bad spirits, Sugar Daddy.
I'm fucking in jail in space, motherfucker.
We all are, but you look even more pissed off than usual, especially given that you have a new arrangement that seems to make you very happy.
Nah, fuck, man. It's all shit. It's all fine. Don't Don't worry about me.
Well, I'd let you know I have some experience as a psychologist. If you need a shrink for free, I'm doing nothing better.
Ned, I'm good, Holmes.
Rest well. Go to leave.
Hi, sugar daddy.
He looks at Hayden and leaves. Night, unless you guys have anything else before sleepy time. Night comes and the lights all flicker off except a low glow in the cell or the cell block. And before any activity can actually happen, you're not sure what is actually happening, but this monitor custodian buzzes out of the cell and heads towards Hayden's cell. And as it gets there, it states, "Priority one, depart cell, stand patiently, obey, 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 obey."
Oh no. I'm standing patiently.
It kind of goes by you and begins to literally toss your room. As it tosses your room, it finds your baton and confiscates it. Contraband, 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 contraband. And re-enter cell, re-enter cell, re-enter cell. Lights out. No contraband. Warning, warning, warning. And it goes down and heads back to its station.
Wonder who did that.
And remove your contraband from your baton from your inventory, please.
Oh, that's good.
So are you going to go into the night?
Oh, even more now.
Yeah, I figure as much. Alright, so describe what you're gonna do here.
So Hayden, why he's staring at Jimmy sleeping. Good Jimmy. And he's gonna walk towards the cell door, and as there would be a reader on inside, no?
You have to reach your hand outside the door, but it's it's facing the other way, but yes.
Alright, he's gonna try to do that.
Click! Your door opens.
Good. And he's gonna be sneakily, just walking along. Can I breathe deep? Feels good. Mosey on to the different room and attempt to use the barcode there.
Click. Opens. Give me a wits roll, by the way.
Oh boy.
Yep, everything seems good.
Alright, he's gonna enter, but he remembers the guards around. He's not gonna be really concerned about them, but he's gonna be concerned at the same time, so it's gonna be like hastily looked, but nothing big.
Give me some. So you wanna try to dash across, or are you trying to be like sneaky about it?
Oh, it's gonna be sneaky.
Okay, give me a reflex. Normal check. Go ahead and go ahead, go across there.
It's closed.
Oh, it's not. Sorry. The monitor seems inert. I'm gonna give everybody sight through your eyes just so they can see what's going on. Give me 2 seconds here.
I don't know. I might want to just hear you describe it for me.
It's up to you guys. What you guys want to do?
Yeah, the description is better.
Yeah, yes. I want to hear it.
Okay.
And you continue going.
Click.
Cypher should probably get sight since he's backup recording, though.
Yeah.
True enough.
Or unless you want the voice coming over the darkness.
Okay. Hold on 1 second.
Yep, I see him.
Give me like a second. These punks back in the room. Okay. Give me a reflex.
I'm just waiting for my cursed rolls to start. But I'm hoping since I've been drinking, I have some doc dice kicking.
Don't tempt fate. If you invoke his name, he fucks you.
Ooh.
Somehow you are like creeping. So how are you like doing this? Like you've passed literally 2 monitors and they haven't seen you.
He's sticking to the shadows, being patient, waiting for the right moments. You know, it's no different than humans. They'll eventually move on to something else. You know, or if not, just not pay attention altogether, it seems. I mean, that's as far as he thinks it. Mm-hmm. You know, because being crazy, and he likes to read humans.
Okay. Yeah, you remember generally where Sugar Daddy is. He's to that cell. He left. You see an outline of someone laying in a cot.
All right. I'm going to stand outside the door and just peer inside for a minute. Seeing with everything.
Mm-hmm. Reflexes.
Oh my god.
Mm-hmm. Just sleeping away.
I mean, obviously trying to be as quiet as he can be, considering that the door is going to unlock or whatever. I mean, he doesn't want to draw unnecessary attention to himself yet. No, from Sugar Daddy.
It clicks open. He does not wake up.
Standing over Sugar Daddy, sees him sleeping like a baby. It's not nice what you do. Tammy is nice. And he's gonna reach for his throat and at the same time attempt to pummel him with his brass knuckles. He's trying to cut off the wind so he can't scream.
Why don't you give me a prowess roll?
Alright, now I do got, before I start getting deep in the the demented insight, once okay. per a day, I can add +1 to any dice roll, so that would imply for after, right?
Yeah, basically, so if you're doing a +1 dice roll, in this case would be, you're rolling, you roll your brass knuckle and you get a +1.
Okay, so I'd have to do it before the declare it before the roll, or would I be able to add it up
after? How does it read again?
It says once per day you may add +1 to any dice roll.
Yeah, it would be after.
Okay, so that way if it does roll bad and it's within reason, gotcha. Just in case it goes south, you know? I just wanted to be sure.
Yep. Roll your brass knuckle instead.
Oh, yep, gotcha. I gotta actually click it on the sheet, apparently.
No, it should be on your token.
Nah, I got the riot baton sitting there in normal checks.
Oh, just do unarmed then. Unarmed is. Brass knuckle and unarmed are the same, except brass knuckle makes it lethal. Yeah. Okay, so he is gonna roll. a D8. Just actually, I'm gonna make him roll a D6. It's just.
I got a 6 out of it.
You did. That's still not good enough. So how does this look as you just bash his head in?
Well, he's gonna have the smile, and I imagine after Hayden hit him the first time, he's gonna wake up and he's just gonna see Hayden's face in front of him with the big old smile. I told you I would see you tonight.
He's reaching up and trying to grab your wrist, but he's unable to get free as you just kind of don't give him any quarter for this brutality. Kind of explain that for us.
So as Hayden gets his first one and he struggles against him, the smile just gets bigger and his eyes just get brighter, fixated at this poor soul's sight. And he's just going to keep hitting them and hitting them and hitting them. And right about the time where he feels himself slipping away, Hayden is just going to reach in and whisper to his ear, I want to see your insides, but I don't have nothing to do it with. And with that, he's going to attempt, maybe not good enough, maybe so, to kind of push into the soft spot of the throat with all his force to see if he could break skin and he could get in.
Sure.
Need to roll for that, or is
nope,
it?
Nope, you do it.
All right. He's going to do it, and he's just going to reach inside through his throat and just grab hold of the esophagus and the tongue and everything like that and start trying to yank it out.
Yeah, after a few minutes, the room is a complete bloody horror show. You have his esophagus, his meat of his throat, just everything, just laying everywhere around you.
Pretty. And then with that, he's also going to step on both his shoulders and grab the head, and he's going to be struggling like a child trying to get his arm out the cookie jar, trying to pop off his head because he wants it.
Yeah, you're unable to get the head off. You probably break the neck, but it's just, you can't get the spine off. It's just too difficult with what tools you have. You're unable to decapitate him by hand.
It was worth the shot. And with that, he'll take his tongue, at the very least, and pick it up. And while he's doing that, he's going to remember that he's the store. And he's going to look around and try to find everything he could find.
Yeah, you find those power cells, 8 of them. But that he was telling you the truth that he didn't have much there. However, you do find 3D100 smokes.
All right, roll that.
...174 smokes you find.
And with that, he's gonna take a somewhat bloody shirt. I imagine it's really bloody, right? Oh, actually, he's not even gonna do the shirt thing. He's just gonna disrobe and rinse himself off in the toilet. And then he's gonna go walking out over here to the next... Now, would there be a sheet in the empty room?
Yeah, you can get a sheet out of there.
Alright, so Hayden will go in, wrap everything up nice in the sheet, totally naked now. Well, because he made sure to keep the convert, number and stuff like that, so that way he wouldn't just be laying there for the guards to find.
Yeah,
he may be simple, but puts it over his shoulder like Santa Claus and moseys on back towards the cell area.
Okay. As you get to the monitor, so you kind of just reflex right about here. Okay. Did not see you. You passed through carrying all this crap through the door. Doesn't see you. Come out into the hall, please. Another reflex.
They're getting higher. You see that? It's getting dangerous.
It's always the return trip.
Like a ghost.
Yeah, you go right through. No one sees you. None of the monitors see you as you kind of get back here.
Alright, and with that, he will go over to Tammy cell.
Alright. Please do.
She's asleep.
He's gonna click it open.
Oh, man. Okay.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Walk inside with all the stuff and silently hide it. But someplace where she would notice it. And there's smokes are in there too.
And this includes the smokes, the bloody tongue, and everything?
Nope. The tongue is still with me.
Okay.
And it's just the power cells and the smokes.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Go ahead and roll. Oh, God. Go ahead and roll. Wits, Tammy.
Alright.
Holy shit.
Are you trying to be stealthy at all?
Yes. I don't want her to know it was me dropping it off, although I'm pretty sure it'll be painfully obvious.
Okay, so you rolled a 6, so what is your wits, Tammy?
Here, I think it's a 9.
Yeah, okay, 9.
So we'll just add it. So you did a 15. Hayden, go ahead and roll your opposed on reflexes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you sleep like, through it.
Like Santa Claus.
And then with that, he's going to walk out.
Do you lock her door?
Yes. I don't want nothing attracting attention to her. And then he's going to walk over to Jimmy's cell.
Poor Jimmy.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
Okay.
Is Jimmy sleeping?
He is asleep, yes.
Oh, sleep, poor baby, sleep. And with that, he's gonna unlock his door.
Roll opposed reflexes. Okay.
Oh, God.
You're literally the boogeyman.
Oh my God.
And he's gonna lay it across his forehead with the tongue dangling down to his mouth over his nose.
Well, that's gonna wake him up. So.
That's all
you're,
right.
You're putting the tongue literally on his forehead?
Yeah, not sliding it. I'm just kind of like putting it down.
He, so Jimmy kind of like brushes at it, like idly, like, you know, like put a feather on somebody's nose, kind of. He's like, And then he kind of like his eyes go up, and first he just sees Hayden as like, and then he just like begins to flail.
And I'll cover his mouth and tell him, "Shh, Jimmy, drop off presents. Dropping off presents. You are good, Jimmy. I like you, Jimmy." With that, he's gonna let him go and walk out the cell. And he goes and lock it. It's just a dream, Jimmy.
And this, he didn't even really notice the tongue at first. And he sees it, he's like, but he's smart enough to cover his mouth as he begins to like hyperventilate and like completely freak out.
And with that, Hayden will go back into his cell. Buck naked, mind you, still.
Oh my god, he did all this naked! Oh my god! That makes it so much better!
Like, the only thing he had was a serial number off his little shirt thing.
So, he's gonna flush like, when you, like, the next day you're gonna be naked?
Yep, naked as can be.
Okay.
And then he's gonna sit down and stare at Jimmy.
Yeah, Jimmy is goes over to the corner and is like just like basically looking down and holding his hands over his face, crying.
And with that, Hayden was just there.
So Tammy, you wake up when the morning comes and the monitors announce to wake up, and you notice there's something kind of strange. Something's a little out of place at your feet.
What? And she'll kind of roll up out of bed, feeling around for her matchbook, and realizing, oh, well, it's still with Hayden. And kind of open this little makeshift gift bag.
Yeah, there's 8 power nacelles in there and a, what did we say? Smokes. There's a bunch of smokes in there.
174 to be exact.
What? Can she like, or can I roll like a wits thing to make some sort of connection?
Yeah, go ahead, because there's something else. So.
Yeah.
Like, this whole thing, he figured it'd be sneaky, but it's not easy. It's not hard to not connect the two, you know?
Yeah, so one thing is very clear. There's blood all over this fucking thing. And you remember that Sugar Daddy had 10 of these batteries to sell, and you bought 2 of them. And so with this would make 10.
She'll kind of look at the bag or the fabric with the stuff inside and just kind of stare at the blood, and she'll kind of scoot back a bit from it and kind of hold her legs to her chest.
Yeah, and you guys, your doors are unlocked, so you can do whatever you want at this point.
Hayden will walk out stark naked. Good morning, Jimmy.
Jimmy is catatonic almost. He's just kind of like, when you get there, he comes back here. Even though his door is unlocked. Just leave me alone, man. Just leave me alone, please.
You didn't like the gift I got you?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know what it is. I don't know about that, man. I'm not here to cause trouble. I'll do whatever you want me to do. Just don't do that to me, okay? Just please, okay?
No. I'm sorry I scared you, Jimmy. It was not my intention. If you want, I will take it back.
Yeah, take it back. I flushed it, I think I flushed it, I don't know, I can't remember, I don't know, man.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry, Jimmy.
Whose was that, man? Whose was that?
Oh, somebody.
No, listen, man, don't even tell me, I don't want to know, I don't care, man, just don't do that to me.
I won't, Jimmy, you're good, Jimmy.
Okay.
And with that, he will just mosey on off into the middle of the cell room. Buck naked.
Yeah, the monitor custodian doesn't seem to notice yet. But as everybody kind of comes out, you hear a lot of commotion coming from the other room right about this time. Where did Manus go? Oh.
Yeah, he just went for a bite. Zero gets up from his bed. This is now what, like, been 4 days since he's on his feet under his own power and volition, per se. So he's gingerly getting off his bed and starts making his way down. Slowly stretching.
Mm-hmm. You see Hayden in the middle of the room naked.
Hayden?
Ah, Zero. Nice to see you walking around.
Nice to see all of you.
Oh,
have you noticed? Are you catching a draft, maybe?
I was wondering why. I think I might have ate my clothes in the middle of the night. I was quite ravenous.
All right. I don't know. At this point, I think nothing you do surprises me anymore.
Hello, Dr. Manus.
Good morning, Hayden. I see that you're taking in the fresh air.
Yes. My clothes seem to have vanished.
Do you require spares?
Answer yes for you, Cypher. Okay. Tammy, do you are you looking out into the square at all?
So Tammy's actually kind of storing away all the power nacelles, stuffing the bloody blanket kind of somewhere quickly just to kind of hide it. And as she kind of looks out to kind of see what's going on, she'll be like, ah! She'll cover her eyes. God damn it!
Good morning, Tammy. Sleep well.
Woke up terribly.
Oh yes, my clothes seem to have gone invisible.
Oh, please make them reappear.
I don't know if I have any more to make them reappear.
I have a blanket that might belong to you.
I don't think it belonged to me. I have mine still.
God. Dr. Manus would check his cell to see if there are any more clothes that are in there.
No.
Because he is disgusted.
So, kind of as you're talking, these two, like, rush from the other cell block, and they're like, what the fuck? You hear the Sarge say. It's the first time you've ever heard him speak. And radio's like, oh man, whoa, Sugar Daddy is fucking dead over there, man. Fucking dead.
Manus perks up at that. Dead.
Dead as dead. Fucking killed, man. Beat to death. Throat ripped out.
When did that happen? We just all got up right now.
Fuck, I do not know, dude. He was fine when we went to bed. We were bullshitting. He was in a bad fucking mood, that's all I know.
Why might that be?
I don't know. Wouldn't say. Wait. He was mad, no. Though.
Shh. What do you mean you woke up and saw him dead?
I woke up, man. I went out of my cell over there and I saw him. He is fucking dead.
In his cell?
In his cell, man.
Throat ripped out.
Throat ripped out. It's a bloody mess. Face just beat to... What the fuck? You're naked, man.
Yes. My clothes seem to have wandered off.
He likes to breathe in the morning occasionally.
Alright, man. You might want to go put some shit on. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, everybody can make a wits roll to kind of put two and two together.
I don't think that the Dr. Manus needs to.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say everybody, unless you like roll a 12 or something. I'm just going to say all of you can kind of put it together. It seems
Zero's great. Standing there, and if anyone's noticing, his body language is extremely tense at this point. And he looks sideways to Dr. Manus and then sideways to Hayden. And he doesn't say anything. But at this point, if they are even watching his body language, it's not pretty.
Is he still in his cell?
The custodians are about to take out the dead body.
Let's go have a look.
Man, they ain't wanting any. They kicked us out. Can't go in there right now.
Dr. Manus, a word, please.
Zero, give me a... So everybody can actually do this. Zero, you're still feeling the effects of the Kimcast. So right now, and probably until the end of the session, your rolls are at a penalty.
Okay.
You're going to be rolling a normal check with a D20. Everybody else can do their normal D12.
A what check?
Wits. You don't need to make it, Hayden.
Oh, okay. I probably wouldn't have anyways.
So everybody made it. It's pretty impressive.
Especially for his life, holy shit.
Yeah, you notice that on Hayden's arm, there is a hack job where someone has cut his arm, burned it, and there's something kind of protruding out of the forearm. As he stands here naked in front of you.
Zero kind of walks up as he moves towards Dr. Manus to have a word with him. Hayden's arm catches Zero's eye and he kind of walks up to Hayden. He says, "What is that?"
"What is what, Zero?"
"On your arm."
"Oh, that was an unfortunate accident from yesterday."
"Yesterday? What happened yesterday?"
"Oh, sometimes the voices tell me to do things, and sometimes I have to listen. Would you like to know what they're saying now?"
"Please, I'm all ears."
"They are ravenous. They need more. More." And with that, his eyes kind of get a little too focused. His eyebrows bend inward. And he looks with a smile. "I need to sedate them and feed them."
"Listen, boy, I'm not some shivering, wimpy little sack of shit in this prison. So you better watch your mouth when you speak to me. I would back off right now, Hayden, or the voices along with you are gonna get buried right here. And if I'm gonna get chem castrate for that, I don't give a shit. Choice is yours."
"Not sure what your issue is. I asked you if you wanted to know."
"Back off."
"What am I backing off from?"
"From me, motherfucker. Now. I'm gonna find out what happened, but if it has got something to do with my property, it is not the place you want to be."
"Your property? Was it your property over there?"
"Seems to be. Something went missing from my cell. And now something has happened on the other side. Because you are not smart enough to just pull it off by yourself. That much I know. A feral dog maybe, but not smart enough." "So you might scare little Jimmy back there and send the shivers down Tammy's spine. but that doesn't work with me. So, I say again, back off.
Again, I am confused. You came over to me.
You seem to have done something that you should not have done. You seem to have played around when you should not have. And you seem to might have fucked us over in the process.
Look around. Everybody here has done something they shouldn't have done. There is nobody here that is free of the guilt.
I'm not talking about guilt, you idiot. I'm talking about our meal ticket in that other room who was going to supply us with stuff. You fucking moron.
Is this your first time here? When one store closes, the other one opens.
Yeah. I think I know what's going to open up when it comes to you.
I'm confused now. Is something supposed to open?
We shall find out soon, shan't we, Hayden?
You guys are arguing, and you notice that Sarge is kind of like over here, kind of peeking out the door, trying to, like, he's like mumbling to himself angrily.
As the, as that very tense conversation's happening, Zero, I believe you wanted a word.
Yes. Enough of the bullshit, Doctor. What happened to my key? And don't tell me somebody threw my cell out and handed the key appropriately to that animal back there.
Zero, I couldn't tell you how or if Hayden has gotten a hold of your key.
Doctor, let's move past the bullshit, shall we? I don't treat you like an idiot. I appreciate if you don't treat me like an idiot. But there is a reason why I'm losing my key right now. Just tell me, does Zero have the key? I don't want to know how he got it. Does he have it? Because it sure as shit looks like he has it.
Well, Zero doesn't, but... You're right. Dr. Manners takes his glasses off, rubs his temples. I believe he may.
Perfect. Oh, fuck.
I have been trying to figure out who it is that may be gunning for us, because I have not had control of Hayden for some time.
Doctor, let me add you to your list. One more person you do not want to be gunning for us. The certain fucker who had me in solitary for those past 4 days. Mm-hmm. So happens that our Mr. Sugar Daddy conduit. I was to pay off Sugar Daddy, who in turn would pay him off. Now the animal back there has just snuffed Sugar Daddy in the most spectacular fashion. What do you think is going to happen next?
It would be bad news for you, and indeed, bad news for Hayden, I imagine.
Yes, but do you for a moment think that's just going to stop there? No. If I have to pull all of you down to that hellhole, I will. So now my problem has become your problem because you let Hayden run free.
Again, I did not let Hayden do anything, and I pull my key out. I promised him this key on certain occasions. I can't speak to how he got a hold of yours. But I would be happy to help you deal with this issue. Here's what I propose. You have radio, yes, just looking over at radio. I know that I wouldn't say anything too radio.
Yeah, he's just kind of, he doesn't want to get involved here somewhere.
This is a man who can speak with many different voices over pipe. I am certain that Sugar Daddy is not the only one who knows of this drain or has an arrangement with your doctor. Radio could put the word out, see if we can figure out this drain for ourselves, and then we make the drops on our own. That solves your problem, doesn't it?
Yes and no. Yes, we find out if we find. But do you not think it's overly convenient I get out of that hellhole and then somebody I'm associated with, someone who seemed to be around me, snuffs out the only contact I have the very next day or the day after? No,
just,
doctor.
Just to interject real quick, the drain is how it gets in here, right? Where Sugar Daddy gets stuff and ferries it to, no idea, because the doctor doesn't come in here, right?
Yeah, correct. So the pipes were to find out where does Sugar Daddy go and drop.
Yeah, I was just making sure it's clear.
Yep, you're right. So, Dr. Manis, it looks like I have been constantly fucked over since I got out of that hole. Some part of it I do take. Sometimes I lose my temper and chaos takes over. No, not this time. This was not my doing. And now I have to fucking clean it up.
Well, I will help you clean it up. But I need to make it abundantly clear Hayden is a mad dog.
The next time, before you give him something, he cut or somehow let him have access to it, because I doubt someone just threw my cell over. Maybe he walked into my cell when I was out. The next time you see him do something stupid like that, please, you seem to have a voice of reason, use it for all our sakes.
I will see what I can do. I will say this. He did spend an inordinate amount of time near your empty cell while you were away. To be honest, he was aware that your key, well, that you had a key, and was not very happy with me for not letting him use mine.
Looks like the asset has just become a liability.
Agreed.
So Hayden over there with Tammy, what are you guys kind of doing as Hayden, you watch Zero kind of go off and talk to Manis, and Tammy's just kind of left over there by you alone?
He was kind of watching, but then he looked over at Tammy. Hey, Tammy.
Hey. Hayden, got your present, I guess.
Oh, you got a present.
I know it was you.
Yes. You've taken a lot of liberties.
I have.
No, he has. Should not be that way.
Is that why you,
Yes, now you got a way to get smokes without doing the things you don't want to do.
Yeah, but there's no the flow. There's no constant.
I'm thinking that you would be able to barter away what you got for the gift, and in return receive smokes, and then find a way to buy more.
Are you suggesting I take t- take over the business?
That way you don't have to do what you don't want to do no more.
Well, I mean, I'm not opposed, but I don't really have his contact as of yet.
Well, radio has a way of passing along messages.
True. Very true. You have a point there.
I told you, you intrigued me.
I appreciate it, Hayden.
I'll look out for you. Keep you safe.
I would like that.
My pleasure.
And you need new clothes. You are highly nude.
Yes. Not sure how to remedy this yet.
I think the good doctor might have some clothing, hopefully, for you. If not, what? I mean, you've got a whole blanket. Just wear it.
I guess the blanket may be able to be used, but I felt the need to feel breezy.
I mean, after last night, probably need some breeze there.
Yes, well, I couldn't very much wear my clothes anymore, could I?
True. Very true. Good after job, Hayden.
You just let me know if anybody else takes those liberties.
Oh, I will happily let you know.
Yes. It was a necessity.
Very much so. Good job.
Now, I would suggest going to talk to radio, but not too soon. You don't want to be tied in with everything.
Oh, no. I'll give it a day.
If you would like, I could go talk to him.
Oh, I don't think that's a very good idea there. But you can come with. I mean, I'll talking. You can do the staring.
It would be my pleasure, Tammy. I would like to see how he talks to his voices. Maybe I could try.
Oh, well, we'll see then.
Now, what do you think is wrong with Zero? He seemed pretty angry about something.
To be honest, he's a little bit hard to predict. I'm not sure what exactly is going on with him there.
He's
surprisingly upset at this arrangement.
He seemed to be speaking in code to me. I did not understand. I was a little confused.
I mean, opening things, you know, kind of in reference to, you know. Did the good doctor give you his key there?
Well, Tammy, I'm gonna head and roll for this one because he's intrigued with Tammy.
Yeah, so. good. All right, obsession. I would say this is. Hold on. Let me read this real quick. How this reads.
All right.
Yes.
Man, this is... this is the one flaw. It's time to fucking deny.
Yeah, go ahead and do willpower.
Okay, it's not bad. I don't hate it.
Alright, willpower it is. Any modifiers?
No modifiers.
Fuck off.
Yeah, you tell her the truth. You just are so enamored with her, you could never lie to her.
And your fucking point. You fucking dickhead.
Yes, tell me.
Yes.
How, Tammy?
Dr. Manis said I could have a key if I hit him. And I hit him. And he gave me Zero's key that he hid. Told me to lie if I was asked about it. But I was never asked about it. Because I really don't need to hold on to the key forever. I just need it every once in a while. I would gladly give it back when nobody's watching.
But
he told me to lie.
Hayden, I mean, you said you only need it every once in a while, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And you know that I want to make sure that no one messes with me anymore. Yeah.
Yes, which is kind of why I like to hold on to it.
Oh.
Because I could go and visit people in their dreams.
True. But, you said you only need it every once in a while. Do you mind if I borrow it?
Oh, yeah. Not at all. As long as you let me use it when I need it.
Whenever you need it, just ask.
My pleasure, Tammy. And with that, he's just gonna reach up his arm, full view, I guess, because
yeah, you're naked.
So. Yeah, and he's obsessed, so he's not even thinking about that. And gonna grab at his arm where it's at and try ripping it out of his arm.
You do.
And he's gonna hand it to her.
She'll take it. Put it away.
Now I'm bleeding again.
Yeah, it's bleeding down your forearm into your hand. And the monitor closest to you rolls over. Basically, calls lunch. So, and then the day would pass. Is there anything you guys want to do during the day here?
Oh, Hayden's gonna smear blood on himself like usual. You know.
So as the monitor sees Hayden, it says, it just like kind of the screen is blank as it kind of doesn't know what to say, and it just says obey, 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 and eventually another monitor comes in with another set of clothes. These monitors seem to have no... they cannot correlate the death of Sugar Daddy and you having no clothes on. Which all the humans obviously can, but these automatons don't have that level of intelligence.
And of course, I'll be wearing my blood on my face like usual, so... The clothes won't be hiding much.
Wash, wash, wash.
That goes my fun.
Shower day, shower, and they begin.
No.
So, they actually begin to filter everyone towards the showers.
Still works the same. Stay by me, Tammy.
Oh, don't worry. You got it.
I'll protect you.
Fucking amazing.
Oh, thank you.
All right, hold on. This game. Why did I ever run it? Okay.
Oh, shit.
So you end up in the showers and, the monitors are ushering people forward.
Sarge goes in first, strips down naked, and heads to one of the dividers and begins to shower. The monitors are in close, close proximity. They do not let people shower alone or with others.
Hayden will, of course, stay close to Tammy, knowing that this is the, what they refer to it as, rape alley.
Yes, someone did.
Somewhere along those lines. Ah, the keyword rape is stuck in Hayden's head. And he'll gladly look at everybody as he's walking with blood all over him. Fascinated look on his face.
And Jimmy should be here too.
Oh, lovely Jimmy. Poor Jimmy. Good Jimmy.
So as you're filing in, who would be next? I'll let you guys decide.
Manus will go.
As Manus is about to go, Zero kind of reaches out on his shoulder and says, "Wait a minute, Doctor." How, like, do we all, like, go in single file, or are, like, people taking showers?
It's basically the single files to get into the showers. Once you're in there, you can kind of spread out, just as this kind of picture depicts. Everybody has, like, their kind of own, not private, but semi-enclosed area where they shower.
And then the
middle of the of the room kind of filters down into a big drain. There's smaller drains around the perimeter of the room, but in the middle is a big, large drain that every kind of thing just filters down into. And this is like the quote-unquote clean water of the... Like, a lot of people just, like, will sit in here and just, like, drink. Although you are given, like, appropriate... water and nourishment at, you know, lunchtime, that sort of thing.
And where are the monitors in this room?
They stand pretty close to the showers, just in case there's any funny business.
Okay. So the drain is kind of somewhere over here.
Yeah, you know, it's like...
Like maybe here?
Yeah, sure.
And the water's all, like, going in there, correct?
Yeah, it just flows from the outside in. It's kind of like a bowl-ish. Not that severe, but it flows down into the middle.
Doctor, I want to unfucking ourselves at this moment lies in me retrieving something from dream. So, I will need your help while I proceed to retrieve it.
And what help would you need?
Some sort of distraction. It seems to be really working model with these monitors. I do not need them to see me retrieve it.
Let us locate it first.
It's in the central drain in that room. Some sort of a chemical in a syringe that I must then hand it over to Sarge at a later time. I don't know what it does. Maybe you can take a look at it before I hand it over to him, just so I know what's gonna do to him. Information is power at the end of the day, Dr. Manus.
Agreed. I will attempt a distraction.
Much obliged.
Give me a signal whenever you intend to go for this drain.
Jimmy is the next one in and goes basically to the furthest shower he can, always keeping an eye on Hayden, but he looks scared, completely shitless. Everyone's certainly on edge.
Oh, Hayden looks happy.
Well, yeah, except you. All the NPCs are on edge, except Sarge. He just seems irritated. But he always seems irritated. Never seen anything.
And Hayden will just briskly once off so he can keep his eye on Tammy, making watching her back, you know.
And Tammy will probably go into one beside Hayden and try to hide herself as much as possible.
Hayden will stand right in front.
Like, oh, good.
amazingly enough, like, these three don't really look at you at all. They might, like, kind of, like, sneak a peek, but they're more interested in not being killed.
Perfect. So, yeah, she'll get all showered up. Bit more relaxed now. Surprisingly, that's Hayden's there.
Zero goes in, undresses, and starts to shower.
Yeah, as you shower your wound on your stomach, you kind of look down at it, and it looks surprisingly decent. The medical care that Dr. Randleman gave you appears that he did a pretty decent suture job, at the very least.
And Zero kind of in some parts had, you know, that part of the memory was blacked out, but seeing the wound again and kind of running his fingers across it, he starts seeing like flashbacks to the pit and the interrogation by Dr. Needles, and he kind of, you know, gets flashes on and off as he's taking the shower, and he sees the face. He assigns the name now, Dr. Randleman. Like, they're all like jumbled in his mind, like, you know, bits of memories that didn't stick together, and now it kind of starts all falling in place. And part of him is happy he's out, but then a part of him is fuming at the way things have turned out. And then he kind of focuses himself and he says, fine, step at a time. Step at a time. As he's done taking a shower, doesn't dress up, but walks kind of to the center of the room. Seems to be like drying himself. For the next bit, I don't know what you want me to roll, but when no one is particularly looking at him, Zero is going to shove a couple of fingers down his throat to activate, like...
Yeah, you still are not feeling that great. You could easily make yourself puke.
Yep. Yeah, so I activate my gag reflex and then immediately get down to all fours and start puking right in the center of the room.
Yeah, the monitors, you see it light up, but it doesn't, like, move forward.
Zero kind of looks up to see if Dr. Manus catches that.
Yeah, and in the... let's see what I can figure out. Are there any monitors that are looking at Zero in particular?
There's just one monitor at the edge of the room looking at the whole thing, but he's kind of obviously drawn attention to himself, so...
Mm-hmm. Is there anyone kind of walking out that's drying themselves or getting dressed?
Most of the people are finishing up their showers. Sarge was in first. He's kind of heading back towards the hallway it's probably the size, double size of a washcloth. That's what you get to dry off with. So he's kind of rubbing that over his body.
Um, Dr. Manus would... Is Jimmy still in here?
Yes, he's still in there. Looking at Zero, like, very scared. Just at everything.
I would kind of move up beside Jimmy, seeing Zero's cue. So, Jimmy.
Oh man, what's going on? Just leave me out of it, man.
There's no need to be afraid, son.
What are you talking about?
I put my hand on his shoulder and then punch him in the face.
So you just like smack him, and he kind of like staggers back, and the monitor immediately like goes over there, as kind of it seems to do, and speeds over towards Jimmy and you with its tranks out, and obey, 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 and the water's like hitting it from the shower, and Jimmy's like, man, come on, man, don't hit me, dude.
It'll be fine, Jimmy. And I just kind of put my hands behind my head, trying to slowly back away, keep the monitor's attention while I look sidelong at Zero, hoping that he's doing what he needs to do.
Zero nods and proceeds to open that drain up to see if he can get to the package.
Yeah, you fiddle with it for a moment, but you're able to... The drain, you notice, is not very tight. You assume is because this thing has opened quite a bit. And you see that everybody else is kind of, like, obvious to very, very, you know, very clear what's going on. The monitors fall this for the ship, but other humans don't usually. And they're just kind of staring at what you're doing. But you pull out a bag, and in the bag you see a syringe, a capped needle in it. And Sarge just goes, think that's mine.
Not yet. Zero kind of wraps it up in his clothes, nods in Manus's direction, and starts walking up.
Sarge gives a look at Hayden momentarily, and then back to Zero, but doesn't say anything. Just kind of walks towards the exit as the monitor like separates Jimmy and Manus with its tentacles, and kind of like keeps them separated and moving along the hallway back into the... Well, you guys tell me if there's anything else you want to do here, but it's going to take you back to the normal room.
Nope.
Nothing from Zero. No, Hayden's, as long as everybody else is playing it cool, Hayden plays it cool.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, nobody's trying anything. Holy crap, no. So you guys get back to the main room. They're still not opening the other cell block yet. So Sarge just kind of walks over to this empty cell and just kind of like gets in there and sits down next to Tammy's cell.
My cell?
Oh, is that you?
yep.
Whichever one's next to yours.
Yeah.
So every radio just kind of is sitting outside, and Jimmy is back in his cell, like... Just hear him kind of whimpering sometimes.
Dr. Manus?
Yes. Mind
looking at this and telling me, in your expert opinion, what do you think it might be?
And put my hand up in my cell. You know that the monitors have eyes.
Indeed.
Okay. What do I see?
Well, it is a liquid, obviously. It has a tint of red to it, but it's got a fairly it's like the gauge of a needle is very normal, that sort of thing.
And it's hard to say without any like thing to really kind of get a good like diagnosis of it when you're just looking at liquid in a syringe.
I have no idea. Unless you plan on having someone test some of it to diagnose the effects.
Well, I'm supposed to hand it to Sarge. And he kind of asked for it in the shower, and I was hoping to understand before I handed it to him. But it looks like we may not.
Do you think he knows the difference?
He might, if he doesn't feel the same effects, if there are any.
What if he felt effects that he had no control over?
Well, say, you have my undivided attention, Dr. Mattis.
Well, Sugar Daddy, bless his heart, may he rest in peace. Pass me off a dose of something. And I go ahead and pull that out, and I'm just remembering what that was.
I can tell you.
It's a dose of jump.
Jump, yep.
A dose of jump. Very powerful uppers, my understanding.
You know what jump is. Well, that seems viable. Give him the jump, and we find out what this liquid is. Because whatever it is, if it doesn't kill him, Dr. Randleman went to a lot of pain to get it to him.
And what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
That's the way I look at things sometimes. We are standing here, aren't we?
Yes.
Fine.
You understand that if this goes poorly, the doctor will blame you.
Yes, indeed. But at this point, I think the doctor is going to blame me for Sugar Daddy's death.
And the Sarge is an older man, though he is firm of constitution. This jump can have adverse effects on one's pulmonary system. It may kill him.
It may.
I'll tell you what. And I have syringes, right?
Mm-hmm. We bought two from... What's his face? Dead man.
Mm-hmm. Dead sugar.
Dead sugar.
Would I be able to... those things are still pretty tight. I don't know if I'd be able to do it or not, but if I could, I would like to try to squirt some of this liquid into one of my syringes, just a little bit.
I mean, you can open the back of the syringe and squirt some in. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I would do that and then have the syringe, and it looks mostly sterile, about as sterile as it will get in here. You want to be a test subject or unwillingly volunteer someone else?
Well, the way I look at it, it could be three things. It could be instant death. It could be a downer. Or it could be an upper. Something better than what jump is, whatever it is. And the only person in this entire block right now looks like needs a mood alteration is, I feel, poor Jimmy over there, who's stuck sleeping next to Hayden. So yeah, I think I would volunteer Jimmy at some point for this liquid. But anyway, those are plans that we need to think about. But at least we have the liquid for us to look at.
And then look at the syringe that has a lot of the liquid left. He's going to expect this before the day is done.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna head over there right now. I mean, if I don't know what it is right now, we have some find out eventually what it could possibly do. And that's still good enough for me. I do not like operating in the dark. And Dr. Randleman, yeah, that's the name of the guy. Mr. Effeminate. I want to know what he's up to.
Of course. I would hand him back the big fuck-off syringe for Sarge. I will find an appropriate time to show Jimmy the brighter side of life, if that's what this does.
Well, let's hope it does. Maybe we can figure out a way to distribute ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, Zero kind of nods to Dr. Manus and heads out towards Sarge's room.
Yep, he's just sitting on the empty cell's bed. Next second, you got it?
I do.
Just kind of looks at you expectantly.
But I'm curious, though. I mean, I'm the one bringing it to you. What is it? I mean, you can have it. I just would like to know, what is it that I'm bringing to you?
Call it Super Red. That's what I'm told.
What does it do?
Think I'm sick. Helps get rid of the sickness.
Sick with what? You seem fine to me compared to the sicko who lives at the end of this row.
Not sick in the head. Brain cancer. Some sort
Can
of
I
chemical.
Roll something to see if he's lying?
No,
push check
yeah.
Or?
Yeah, you do wits.
It's supposed
Remember,
to.
Remember, you're rolling a d20.
D20, yes.
Took a guy's brain cancer meds. I think it was just a regular. Oh, no, I suppose.
No, I wanted a regular, but.
Okay, I can do a regular.
So, 13, you rolled a 13. Your wits is a 10, so you failed anyway. So, he. You don't know. I mean, there's nothing. It's obvious about what he's saying. Shrinks the tumor. Been paying my ass off with smokes for 3 years now.
To a certain doctor.
Mm-hmm. Who else can make this shit?
Tell me about this doctor.
Probably know just like you do. Weird little fella. Real creepy.
You met him the same way as I did?
You were in solitary, I guess, for cutting Slag's throat.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, something like that.
And you used to pay him through good old Sugar Daddy over there?
You got it.
You ever found out how Sugar Daddy made the payment back?
No way, man. Sugar Daddy was tight-lipped on that shit.
Well, you seen any regulars sugar daddy or someone who looked like taking bringing stuff more often than the regular Joe?
I don't know, man. He had contacts with the Ultramax psychos, the jailhouse giants, all kinds of people. Lunchtime, I don't know if you noticed, he never sat down for one fucking minute. I don't even know if he ever ate. Walks around, talks to people.
Right. Fuck it. Here's your syringe.
Thanks, man. He takes it and kind of stuffs it in his pants.
So tell me this, that sugar daddy, you have no supply, do you?
Nope.
And how often do you get these syringes?
Every 2 weeks.
Every 2 weeks. And the syringe lasts you a two-week time span, or you take it in one little shot?
I just shoot it up and then it does its work. But no cure for this cancer. Just gotta keep the tumor small. So I take this shit and it doesn't.
So I guess we'll find out what happens when you don't take it.
The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kill your friend. This is causing me a lot of problems. Hope that's not a problem for you. Don't got any problem with you.
I wouldn't do that, Sarge. I mean, yes, he has vexed me today. But every dog has its use.
So how are you gonna ensure I get my supply of this shit? Somebody's gotta make right by me. This was a real stupid fucking thing. Sugar Daddy was a fucking pimp. But he got shit in here that we needed, that we wanted. Now we don't got shit. So I tell you, you make right by me, and Radio, and even Pussy Jimmy. And I won't do something that you might not want me to.
Yeah, story of mine. All right. You have 2 weeks, right? We need your next dose.
You got it.
Well, for 2 weeks, don't move, sit tight. Don't kill that guy. While I try and figure out how to unfuck this fuck up.
14 days. You got it. Day 15, 13. I don't have it. And he makes like the gun symbol and just kind of like does a thumb trigger, which might be a little telling to you.
Zero nods and starts heading back to his cell.
And as you walk out, the doors to the other cell block open, and one of the monitors comes wheeling out with Sugar Daddy's limp body across its tentacled arms, and it just kind of rolls next to Hayden, and you guys all see the just disgusting, his face is just smashed in. You can barely tell, you know, what was a face. It just looks like a piece of meat, and his throat is ripped apart viciously, like someone took a dull spoon and just raked at it over and over and over again. And it just kind of move, and it just kind of goes by Tammy as it heads out. And any reactions as the thing departs the cell block and the scene fades to black? Go ahead.
Start with Hayden and Tammy.
Hayden, go.
Oh, Hayden's just fixated watching it go by. Almost emotionless. Not happy, not sad, just neutral. like almost like a predator watching the prey frolic in the fields before it goes.
And Tammy, seeing the body, all our gag reflexes pretty much instantly triggered, seeing that much gore and just meat ripped apart. She kind of puts her hands just on her thighs as she bends over and just vomits all over the floor.
Zero sees the monitor passing by. Annie grimaces, pinches the bridge of his nose. Fuck. And he kind of turns around and is staring at Hayden as the monitor passes him by.
Man, it's... We'll hear the move. It's coming out after putting away his implements and looks over. Sees how brutally battered that the body of Sugar Daddy is. Thinks to himself, a useful asset. A miserable waste of flesh. Shaking his head at how absolutely barbaric Hayden must have been. But not bad. And then walks back into his cell.
And with that, the monitor reaches the door. It opens automatically, and the automaton and its dead body that is carrying disappear from view. And about that time, lights out, and everyone heads back to their cells as the scene fades to black. And
that's where good night, radio.
Oh, God.
Good night, Tammy.
Good night, Hayden.
Good night, Jimmy. John boy.